Hello everyone, Mathematics Society IIT Delhi warmly welcomes you all to the second episode of GapFest, a series of talks with professors. After a fantastic start last month, today we are privileged to have the Honorable Professor N. Shravan Kumar as our second guest. Although our guest's achievements are challenging to summarize in a short monologue, but I'll try to give a brief introduction about him. He did his MSc in Mathematics from IIT Madras in 2004 and PhD from Ramanujan Institute for Advanced Study in Mathematics, University of Madras, India in 2011. And after that, Sir joined IIT Delhi in 2012 as an assistant professor and is still serving as an associate professor. He has a keen interest in abstract harmonic analysis on locally compact groups, harmonic analysis on hypergroups and operator algebras. Also, Sir has authored and co-authored over more than 50 research papers with topics ranging from the compact groups, Fourier analysis, harmonic analysis, etc. And each year, the number of research papers Sir authors is increasing. So now, without taking any more of your time, let's know about the life, career and interaction of a guest with mathematics and further learn from him about his research interests and career opportunities for the students in those domains.
So sir, what activities apart from academic do you like to engage in your free time?
First thing, what do you mean by a free time? I don't understand.
So there is no free time, like all the time you're working.
Second thing, mostly apart from my office official work and household activities, if I find time, I'll usually read books.
That's great to hear, sir.
It's the right time that I'll have to learn things. I cannot start reading during my retirement.
Yes.
So, sir, what kind of books do you like?
One is, of course, mathematics.
Yes,
second
sir, definitely.
One is mostly I read this kind of spiritual things. So there are few. Have you heard of Devdutt Patnaik? Yeah, so Devdutt Patnaik is one of the famous writers who has written many books. Especially, well, most of the books are meant for people. Especially for people in the age of 15 to 30. It is worth reading.
We'll look into it.
There are lots of books. His perspectives, the way he looks into things. And there is a recent, well, not very recent, but still, there is a collection, huge collection, what is known as Game of Life, Ramayana, the Game of Life.
So when was it when you decided to become a professor and why a professor? I mean, there are many more opportunities.
So, well, initially during my BSc, I could find many of my teachers, they are free. They spend lots of time just like that. I thought that, this is the one of the jobs where you can find lots of free time. And I do not know what to do for one to get into this kind of profession. Especially professors and becoming a teacher, one do not know. But someone suddenly told me that there is a program called program in IIT for mathematics. What is that program for mathematics and what will people do there? I just learned, suddenly my brother, he told me that, yeah, there is an institute called IIT. Just apply, there is a program called MSc. Why don't you apply for that? And I asked him that, will that lead for me to the job of teacher? He said, just like that, apply, we'll see what is going to happen. And then I applied. I got a seat for MSc in IIT Madras. And by the end of first year, I realized that teaching is not an easy job. It requires lots of patience, lots of understanding of mathematics if one wants to do, especially if one wants to do become a mathematics teacher, and especially if one wants to get into places like IIT, then I realized that one will have to teach BTech courses, which means one needs a proper understanding, which means that what my college teachers were doing, they were having free time and all those things, that much is not enough. So that was the time I realized that yes, I should work hard, so that that will alone lead me to the profession of teaching.
Like what you first thought on becoming a teacher, that you will have spare time, and now the first question, as you said, you do not even have spare time from all the things, so it's kind of not what you looked for.
Exactly. So especially if you get into places like IIT, these institutes are too fast. In fact, I always tell my students that IITs are too fast, in particular this IIT Delhi. Oh, it's too fast. Before you open your eyes, many things gets over. I joined this institute as an assistant professor, but many things happened in between, so many things. So students just now, they joined for BTech, but by the time first quiz is over, they get settled, the first quiz is over, and then minor one will have to do the corrections, teaching. Once you finish it, you will see that yes, there are, it's time for quiz two. By the time you finish, get settled, you will see that it's time for question paper setting, you will have to go for minor two. There is an in time for invigilation, and then again correction, you give the papers back. Now it's time for quiz three, re-minor, re-quiz, so many things, you'll be filled with so many things again. And again, once you finish all these, give back the question papers, answer scripts, and now it's time for question paper setting for the major.
That's absolutely true, sir.
It's fully packed. It's a absolute package.
Like, the first semester was over and I didn't even realize I'm in college. The first semester was over. So, like, what is the best thing you feel is about being a professor?
I could see a variety of students. This is the first thing that I could, especially I could feel the students. It's a, in fact, believe that when you say IITs, IIT means it's only the topmost cream. No, that is not the case. First thing that everyone should understand, that it is not that IIT means cream. It's generally a belief. Of course, the cream of this country comes to IIT, but there are other students who come here for reading, especially in terms of education, there are variety of students who come for education. And this is the first thing that I observed as a teacher. Just few years before, a fellow came to my room and he told me that, sir, I couldn't attend the major because my mother was not well. I said, fine, you can take the remajor. It took 5 minutes for him to leave my table and reach the window door, especially. I asked him, why are you too slow? Sir, we have a family disease. By the time we reach age of 25, our eyesight is gone. And I told him that, why don't you go to AIIMS? Talk to the doctors. And he told me that, no, sir, we have already spent 15 lakhs for this. And all the doctors have said that among 10 crore, this is a disease. 10 crore families, this is a disease. Once in a 10 crore family, this is a common disease, which till now there is no medicine. So when you come to know about this kind of things, only then I understand that, yes, the kind of research that is expected in this world, what kind of research that one should do. There are variety of diseases, variety of things that one should know, and how to handle with students. Third thing that I learned is how to handle with students. You cannot just like that handle a student. Handling a student is something, in fact, I always feel that it's the most difficult job. Especially the first years. Because they, you cannot treat them as a school kid, but they have just come out of the schools. And still many, you can find that many students, they still have that school behavior. So treating them is the most difficult one.
Yes, sir, we agree to every single word. Sir, we saw that your main research area is abstract harmonic analysis. So yes. Can you please describe it in for a non-mathematician? What is it?
Of course. So harmonic analysis is in a sense like how do you treat signals? Whether it is electrical signal or a radar signal, whatever be the signal, how do you treat signals? Especially, to be more specific, how do you get back the original signal? That is the most important, because there are various transforms. So now, whatever be the instrument that you have, the signal that you get is not going to be continuous. What you will get is only discrete data. So one thing, first thing, how do you interpret the data? And based on the data, how are you going to retrieve the original function?
Okay, so sir, any applications of this if you want to share?
Yes, so of course, signal analysis, or time, more generally time frequency analysis. Now that there is a huge group in Austria where they are working in as a combination of learning theory and harmonic analysis in the context of what is known as diabetes, blood glucose and all those things. Of course, abstract harmonic analysis, it has got enormous amount of applications in the field of quantum, whether it is quantum mechanics or quantum information, quantum circuits, quantum gates. And you can notice that it is only the harmonic analysis that is behind this. So in 1970s, it was Harishchandra. Of course, he's a student of Dirac. But he doesn't want to work in physics. Although his thesis was in physics, he thought that his thesis involves what is known as the group SL2R. And he wanted to understand this group. But somehow or the other, he started working on a more large class of groups, what is known as the semi-simple Lie groups, and the harmonic analysis behind these groups. And while working throughout all these things, he defined, apart from the Fourier transform on all these groups, he defined a class of transform on these groups. Well, and they were also generalized to a more general, what are known as homogeneous spaces or quotient spaces. And he did not realize that they will have applications. He had some 30-40 papers, and in few years they found that it was those spaces which helped in X-ray, Xerox, and all those things. So we do not know whether these transforms are useful today or not, but tomorrow they are going to play an important role.
Yes, sir, definitely. This is what happens in mathematics most of the time.
So one such example is the usual number theory. If you look at number theory till 1960s and 70s, it's one of the purest subjects where you will never find an application. many companies, now that they wanted people who are working in the area of number theory, especially periodic number theory, because they are very, very useful in the context of security and then coding theory, cryptography.
Sir, are there any opportunities you want to share with us, like a student pursuing for abstract harmonic analysis? What do the opportunities do he have?
Opportunities in what sense?
In
terms of job or in terms of research?
In terms of research.
Of course, there is a huge group in this whole world. Every country has got lots of harmonic analysis people. This is one thing. And whoever wanted to, in the sense like, whoever is interested in, especially in functional analysis, this is one of the, this will be their cup of tea. That's what I'll say. Because I do not know what is harmonic analysis when I wanted to do, when I went to my supervisor for PhD. Because when I was about to leave IIT Madras, a faculty by name Radha, she joined. That was the time she joined. And everyone told me that, oh, she works in harmonic analysis. I thought that it is some part of mathematics which I'm not going to work. So why should I bother about all these? But in another few days, I went to my supervisor. I asked him that, I told him that I wanted to do PhD under you. Will you be ready to take? He said, yes. He filled the form, everything. And in the form, he simply wrote analysis. I don't even know that I'm going to work on. And one day he asked me, have you done any course on Fourier analysis? I told him that, yes, there is a book on Apostle, which has got two sections, chapters, one on Fourier series, the other one on Fourier integrals. And in the first semester I was taught. So, you know, he laughed at me and then he said, he gave me a different book to read. The contents were something far from what I have read. And after some days, he gave me a book on harmonic analysis. I asked him, why should I read all these books? Because you are going to work in harmonic analysis. Oh, is this what is harmonic analysis? Only then I realized this.
So what research are you working on right now?
One is about what is known as the Fourier algebra. The Fourier algebra on an ultra-spherical hypergroup. Because these nowadays, hypergroups are turning out to be very, very important in many contexts. And so, and this Fourier algebra was defined very recently. So that is one of the active areas of research. So I'm working on that. That is one thing. And second thing is about what is known as optimal extension of operators. Optimal extension of operator. Well, being a harmonic analysis fellow, what I'm working is mostly on optimal extension of operators related to harmonic analysis. How far can you extend the so-called convolution operator and also multiplier operator, Fourier transform operator, apart from the classical L1, L2, LP, all these spaces, how far can you extend these? And the third one is what is known as Hausdorff-Fink inequality, which is one of the, of course, it's a classical problem in 1940s, which dates back to 1940s. But now that there are lots of vector valued analogs of all these, so again, the maximal possible groups for which these hold, that's what we are trying to work out.
Sir, can you share some mathematical result that you are most fond of?
Yeah, so one thing that I'm always fascinated is the spectral theorem, which is always my favorite, in fact, I should say. Because when I was taught the spectral theorem during my MSc, I never thought that, yes, that it will have an infradimensional analog. And in the operator theory course, I was informed that it holds only for compact operators. But finally, when I read that it holds for a more larger class, what is known as you can do this whole theorem, whatever you have, for a commutative C-star algebra, it was the fascinating result that I really enjoyed it. When I read the proof, how it works and all those things, that was really, that is one thing. The second thing that I really enjoyed, well, during my MSc is the three pillars of integration, especially convergence theorems, monotone convergence theorem, and then this bounded convergence theorem, and then the last, Fatou's lemma. These three theorems, I really enjoyed those theorems. And the next one, I should say, yes. Yeah. Well, of course, there are lots in harmonic analysis, which I always enjoyed. Yeah, so, well, I'll not to say that this is because of I proved this result, but somehow there is something called what is known as projection theorem for sets of spectral synthesis. It was proved in 1970s by Reiter. Of course, it is part of his book. And of course, he proved it only for abelian groups. How does one prove it for a non-abelian group was a big question mark for several years. And there were only partial results in that direction. And as part of my thesis, I was trying to prove something. And as a result, we could prove that result without any difficulty. And we did not realize that one when we proved it, but when we communicated the paper, the reviewer, they remarked us that, you have solved an open problem. Only then I realized, we have actually done something okay.
Oh, that sounds great.
If you have published a paper in the second year and if you have written two more papers, then you will not worry. Because at the end of second year, when I finished reading a book, my guide simply told me that, Shravan, you have learned the basics of abstract harmonic analysis. So it's now time for you to come up with a problem. So I don't even know that, I'll have to search for a problem. Only then I realized it. So it took several years, two years, I will have to work for it to come up with a problem. Because any problem that I bring, my guide will simply say that, there is nothing. This is a very old problem which you will not be able to solve. This is not worth for thesis. He'll simply finish everything. And finally, somehow, I could get a problem. By God's grace, I got a problem and he also accepted. And he told me that, if you are successful, then you should be able to at least write one paper. So finally, I got my first paper in the fifth year. After several hard work, several things, I could find one problem and we could solve it successfully. And if the comments are positive, then you will really feel happy.